Hello, it's Scott Manley here, and on Sunday night we had a lunar eclipse, which of course meant that it was going to be cloudy. Yes, well, I spent a lot of time looking around to see if a gap would open up in the clouds, trying to shoot whatever I could find between it, and lo and behold, just about halfway through totality, we suddenly got clear skies and I was able to actually get some decent pictures and video. But some people managed to catch more than just the blood red moon. If you look carefully around the 10 o'clock position, you'll see a small flash of light. Here it is again, about 4 times slower. It just turns on for like 1 frame and then goes away. Again, zooming in, there it is, really obvious. More importantly, this flash was recorded in at least 3 different streams that people have found, so this is almost certainly an event which happened on the moon. Now, I haven't gone and done the math or anything on this, so we don't really know exactly what kind of energies we're talking about, but you know, for the last 15 years or so, scientists have actually been watching the moon looking for these impacts. They wouldn't usually watch during a full moon because, of course, a full moon is too bright, but the dark sides of the moon, they can see these flashes created by these impacts. Over the years, the teams have discovered hundreds of impacts. This particular set of video sequences is from a project called MIDAS, that's Moon Impact Detection and Analysis System, and it's run by Jose Madiedo in Spain. One of the things I like about this kind of astronomy is that it doesn't need telescopes that are meters across. The hardware that's used for this are telescopes that you can pretty much buy online in, you know, a high-end astronomy catalogue. You know, there are astronomy fans I know that have telescopes that are larger than this in their backyard. Although the research-grade hardware will typically use infrared and optical and pairs of telescopes a long way apart. Now, one of the largest impacts was observed in 2013, and it was observed by a crew at NASA. It was observed both in visible and infrared, so they were not only able to see the flash, but they were able to see the afterglow as it cooled down. Based on this profile, they were able to estimate that the energy was equivalent to about 5 tons of TNT. Also, the same night, there had been an unusual number of meteorites coming from a particular radiant direction. So they surmised that it must have been about 40 kilograms and located its impact site in Mare Imbrium. The prediction was that it would produce a crater about 20 meters across. So, of course, they went looking with the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter, and this is what they found. A new impact crater was discovered that must have been formed between February 2012 and July 2013, and it was roughly the right size. So this was, you know, one of the first examples of a meteorite crater being found on the moon based on observations on Earth. And there are many other examples that have been found since then. Now, it's going to be hard to actually figure out the energy of the event because I'm presuming that none of the regular telescopes would have been watching during the eclipse, so they didn't have this whole infrared and visible stuff working together in concert. They do have a lot of different amateurs that were taking pictures, so while it may not be possible to calibrate the amount of energy, there are internet sleuths already working on trying to figure out where it impacted so that the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter could be put to work locating it, and perhaps after finding it we can get a little more clues about this surprise visitor to everyone's lunar eclipse. I'm Scott Manley. Fly safe.